The topic is computing partial derivatives algebraically. So let's do the first example. First example says, let f of xy equal x squared y to the 7th plus 5x to the 4th y plus y. And let's find partial derivative of f with respect to x. All right, so first thing, you need to get familiar with the notation. All these notations are the same. Partial f with respect to x is the same thing as f sub x, is the same thing as z sub x. So let's read the definition. The definition says, to find f sub x, or partial f with respect to x, we regard y as a constant and differentiate f of xy with respect to x. This means WRPCT means with respect to x. All right, so let's do that. We're trying to find partial with respect to x of x squared y7 plus 5x4 y plus y. So this is going to be equal what? First thing, think of partial derivatives. When you do partial derivatives, since one is hold constant, so all those derivative properties will hold. So, for example, we can use this property. What does this property says? The derivative of the sum of functions is equal to sum of the derivatives. So we can say this is equal partial with respect to x of x squared y7 plus partial with respect to x of 5x4y plus partial with respect to x of y. Again, I'm gonna use next, I'm gonna use this property. If you have a constant times a function, you're trying to find the derivative, you can pull the constant out. Now think about this, we're taking partial with respect to x, then y7 is considered constant, so I can take it out. So this will be equal y7 partial with respect to x of x squared. Same thing, this y is considered a constant, we take it outside. So it's y partial with respect to x of 5x4 plus, since this is a constant, partial of a constant with respect to x is just zero. Maybe I need to add, well, this property is, let me add it here. Derivative of a constant is zero. So I kind of like use this to come up with this zero. All right, so what's next? The rest is pretty easy. This is y7 partial with respect to f of x squared. So now we're just taking regular derivative. So this is 2x plus y. Think of a derivative with respect to x of 5x4. 5 times 4 is 20. 4 minus 1 is 3 plus 0. So this is going to be equal, let's write it here, so 2xy7 plus 20x cubed y. So that would be the answer. Alright, so let's do partial of f with respect to y. Alright, now same thing, partial with respect to y of x squared y7 plus 5x4y plus y is equal to, now again, if you read the definition, which is number 2, to find partial of f with respect to y, we regard x as a constant and differentiate f of xy with respect to y. So again, I'm using this rule. So this will be equal partial with respect to y of x squared y7, this is 7, plus partial with respect to y, 5x4y, plus partial with respect to y of y. Now this is going to be equal to what? Remember, x squared now is regarded a constant, so I can take it outside. In other words, I'm using this rule again. It's going to be equal x squared partial with respect to y of y7, plus, and again, 5x4 is considered a constant, I take it outside, partial with respect to y of y, right, plus partial of y with respect to y. Let's leave it. We'll do it next one. Now this is in the next step. This is going to be x squared. Partial with respect to y of y to the 7 is 7y6. Again, this is 5x4. Partial of y with respect to y is 1. Partial of y with respect to y is 1. Now this is going to be equal 7x2y6 plus 5x4 plus 1. We're done with example 1. Now let's move to example 2. Let f of xy equal x cubed y squared times x cubed plus y3. Now this is an easy way and there is a long way. So let's do it both ways so you can see the difference between the two. We're still going to get the same answer, but one is much shorter. So the quicker way will be partial of f with respect to x is the same thing as partial with respect to x. So what we do is actually distribute first. What should I write it? Let me just write it here. So if we distribute, x cubed times x cubed is x6, y squared. Y squared times y cubed is y5, so that would be x cubed y5. So I'm going to take partial derivative of this function. It's quicker. So this will be x6 y squared plus x cubed y5. Make sure I didn't make mistakes. 6y2. Then x3, y5, yep. Now this is gonna be what? This is gonna be partial with respect to x of x6, y2, plus partial with respect to x of x cubed, y5. So I'm just adding, I'm doing partial of the sum is equal sum of the partials. Now I'm gonna take the constant outside. So this will be equal to y squared partial with respect to x of x6 plus y5 partial with respect to x of x cubed. And I'm done. 6, derivative of x to the 6, 6x5. So that would be 6x5 y2 plus derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. Don't forget the y5. So this is the quickest way. But of course, let's do it the long way and see what will be the difference. If you do it the long way, means if you use the function the way it's written here, partial of f with respect to x, of course we mean here f of xy, we just don't write it. This means we need to use product rule. So we need to regard, in other words, we need to use this property. So we need to think of this as f and this as g. Two functions. I don't want to confuse it with this f. So f and g, f of x and g of x. So that will be partial with respect to x of x cubed y squared times x cubed plus y3 plus partial with respect to x of x cubed plus y3 times x3 y2. Now this is going to be equal to, now I'm going to take the y squared outside, so y2 partial with respect to x cubed times x cubed plus y cubed plus partial, let me do it in two steps, partial with respect to x of x cubed plus partial with respect to x of y3, all of that times x3 y2. Now this is going to be equal to y2, this is going to be equal 3x squared times x cubed plus y cubed, partial of x cubed with respect to x to be 3x squared plus, this is a constant, so 0 times x cubed y squared. Now this is going to be 3x squared y squared times x cube plus y cube, and this will be 3x squared times x cube y2. Now I gotta distribute. 3x squared times x cube is x5, y squared, plus 3x squared, y squared times y cube is y5, plus 3x, 2 plus 3 is 5, y squared. Now I'm going to add those terms, like terms. This is going to be 3 plus 3, 6, so 6x5, y2, plus 3x squared, y5. And if you notice, this answer is the same as that one. But of course, you want to do it this way because it's quicker. Now let's do partial of f with respect to y. Now we're going to, of course, do the shortcut. So let's use this one. This function, it's the same function, but it's written in a simplified form. So that would be partial with respect to y of x6, y2 plus x3, y5, which is equal to partial with respect to y of fx6 y2 plus partial with respect to y of x3 y5. Now the x is constant, so I can take x6 outside. Partial with respect to y of y2, again take x3 outside. Partial with respect to y of y5, and I'm done. Partial with respect to y, y squared is 2y, so that's 2x6y, plus partial of y to the fifth, 5y squared, so 5y squared. That will be the answer, and that's it for these examples.